Hey guys, I'm Roadbrook Gaming, and in this video, I'm going to be playing Super Mario Maker 2, which came out on the on June 28th, which was yesterday when I'm filming this, though when it's finished editing, it might be a few days later. And I did do some recording yesterday, but the footage didn't come out really good. But nothing, I didn't really do anything important. I just went through the tutorial and made this little basic stage here. So, and it wasn't really that interesting anyways. I just was really quiet and didn't say that much. But anyways, I'm going to be, doing some stuff in this video and going along with the story mode. Because if you didn't know, in Mario Maker 2, there's actually story mode that you can play. And I haven't looked at the story mode at all. I've only done the course maker stuff. So I'll start with that first. If you guys want to see, I made this world that I decided to call Snowy. And if I go to the beginning. If I go here, start here. So it's a really basic thing. So basically they added a bunch of new themes into older games for this. So now there's a snowy theme in the original Mario. And I decided to make my first world like this because I thought it seemed fitting. A little mushroom here. There's nothing. Yeah, it's not really that complex. Just put a few coins here and there. Yeah, so it's a relatively easy level. It's not really that hard. And I can like grab Mario and just move him. So I'll just put Mario here at the beginning. Apparently I can't do that because he's off screen. But anyways, enough of that nonsense. Let's go and try out the story mode, shall we? So I'm going in here blind. I have no idea what I'm going to be seeing. Hey, look, this little. All of the toads in Mario are in their special hats. Yeah. Well, it wasn't easy, but we finally finished the castle. We couldn't have done it without you, Chief. Princess Peach will be thrilled. Yes. Yay! Woohoo! Oh no! There's a reset rocket! And it's the undo dog. And now the whole castle is gone.
No! Mamma mia!
Well, that's an interesting story mode. Rebuild the castle. I can't believe it! Princess Peach's castle! We have to rebuild it, but we've used up our entire budget. I'll handle it. Of course! You can collect enough coins for starting to build. We can make a bigger and better castle! See the taskmaster to scrap together a few things? That's you. So, I wasn't eavesdropping or nothing, but I kinda sorta overheard your entire conversation with the chief. Okay then. Lucky for us, I got a line on some jobs around the world. If you complete enough jobs, you should be able to make enough coins to rebuild the castle. I gotta say, knowing you're gonna single-handedly fund this entire construction effort really takes the pressure off me, you know? Okay, no time to waste. Let's check out this job from someone named Goomba Lover. Most of these clients don't use their real names. I don't ask too many questions as long as they cough up the coin. I made a course full of Goombas. The first one to the goal pole gets paid. Here's a tip. Tilt the L on downward slopes to wipe out the Goombas. I'll get 100 coins. So basically, we get sent difficult levels, and if we beat the levels, then we get money. And that makes it further in the story mode. Okay then. And I guess 1-ups actually matter, because I actually have 6 1-ups and stuff. And those, like, go up and down with the game. Ooh, firepower. How do I even use firepower in this game? Oh, press that one. Okay. This is fun. Just want to make sure there's nothing in these blocks. Check all the sound effects. I'm guessing Goomba Lover stage is just a normal stage. Hey, look, another 1-up. It's like in the original Mario Maker. Wait, what? Star power? I guess you get star power from 1-ups. I didn't know that was a thing. How did I get down there? Maybe using these the secret pipe? There we go. Whee! So I guess instead of like star coins, there's just 10 coins. So that's like to give me more. And remember, I need to collect coins. Because even if we get 100 coins for free for beating it, we still need to collect some more coins anyways. So I got 25 coins. I hope you like this kind of... I hope you like these kind of games because it's like I'm kind of tired of doing Breath of the Wild for the 100th time. And there was actually a Breath of the Wild video in the editing, but it might take a long time because of some mistakes that happened halfway through. Okay. Hello, Chief. You're back. I hope you have some good news. Are you able to get some coins? Nice. Okay, so, Foundation, 100 coins. We do have 100 coins, so why don't we use those? There we go. So I guess you have to wait for a certain amount of time before those things happen. What's off to the side, if I were to... Here's the dummy. Underdog. See that button around? I want to jump on it again. No. I'm not going to let you jump on it. Ooh. Can't jump on these. Hey, what's this? Funny, there's like a little small overworld section. And there's a sleepy toad. That looks like it might be like a tournament thing because of the way the blocks are shaped. And I guess these are all other areas that will be unlocked later. Okay, so I guess I'll go to the next thing. You can run the same job as many times as you want. You don't get paid, but you can get coins that you collect. So I can go back to Goomba thing, but I won't get the reward, but I'll still collect coins during the stay. The on-off switch. So it's like a research on the on-off switch, and I'll get money for testing it. By Dr. Gizmo. I have a feeling that these are still, like, not real people yet, and that eventually they'll be real stages, but, like, not for a long time. So, like, toggle blocks. Mushroom! I'll set that just in case, yeah. Just in case you need to do. And now let's do toggle block again. Alright. Bam! Taken out. There's so many new blocks and stuff. Cause I've seen videos of people playing the older games, but I've never actually seen anyone. I've never actually played the older games myself. I guess you don't get star power from the checkpoints. Oh, it's a mushroom. I guess I have to time it correctly. Darn it. Is this even worth it? I think I broke it. Oh well, I guess I'm not getting the reward then. Take that. Oh, a secret world. Well, this is like the other end. But wait, if I time it right. Star! My star power ran out just at the end. Luckily, I got those extra lives, so it won't be completely ruined. Maybe this will be fixed now. Yep. I did it! Maybe I can get another one. One up farm. Any more? Okay. I guess you only get three shots. There we go. Now it's time to get that one up again. And hopefully it won't fail, because not only do we lose a life every time. Not only do we lose a life every time we game ends, we also lose 10 coins, which are 10 coins less than what I believe we need. Ugh. It's just like a move fast thing, and I'm still not that good at this game, so my reflexes might not be on point. Perfect! And go, 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 go! Made it! Just in time! But now I need like an on-off switch there. Oh! There's a Koopa. Maybe if I hit this Koopa? It's like a constant toggle. 2 coins and run. So yeah, I think that Mario Maker 2 seems to be just as fun as the original Mario Maker. So I collected 48 coins and had 100 on top of that, so. And now the foundation is slowly, we're 1% done with the castle. That's like, how long are we gonna be here? So I guess for every job I do, the farther they get in construction. It's not like an actual timed thing. Hello, 3D world. I planted all these cute trees. Climb trees with L. I haven't weeded the garden, but piranha plants just stomped into the dirt. So yeah, this story mode is definitely a lot more fun than I thought it would be. It's like the first 3D game inside of a 2D game. Perfect. Whee! Darn it. This is hard. Might not be hard for other people, but for me it seems difficult. Say. Maybe if I hold down the button when I jump off. There we go. We need all the coins we can get. So every coin we get is a little more powerful. Well, there goes my extra. Maybe there'll be another one. There we go. How do I get through there? Maybe there's like a Koopa or something. So if I was Big Mario, I could break through that, but and collect the 10 coins, but there's nothing under there to stop me from falling to the abyss. So what's the point? And these are cat paws. Well, wait. Maybe if I saved my mushroom, I would have gotten cat power. Well, that's some mildly annoying. Oh, it's like a speed boost effect. Mushroom! Come on back. You might have seen a little pause break right there, or maybe just like a weird cut, and that's because there's a small storage issue with my phone, and so I had to go deal with that, but I think that and it's all settled, which means that I can continue playing, so. I remember I was here before. There we go. Yeah. Still some fun here. See, now I have a cat suit! Yay! How do I scratch? There we go. Cute. Oh, I lost my cat power! Which means I can't scratch up the wall. Ground pound it is. And when you ground pound, it goes all in one piece. Nice. There's a 30 coin thing, which has been very useful. But I guess. Hey, look, another cat bell. Should I try to go for the 30 coins? Oh well. So big mustn't be too hasty with that. Okay, enough fooling around. I think it'd be better if I just went with it. Just keep going. To find a way to get more lives. The cat fell down, I can just swipe at that. Swipe, 2, 3, 4, 5. Nope. Yeah, there's no need for that coin anyways. Yeah, it definitely helped me get towards my goal for the thing. Really? I can add parts? Well, it looks like I have a limited number, so I don't think I'd want to do that. Should probably get the mushroom. I don't know. It's always good to have a little... Always good to have a little bit of... you know... reassurance. Need those 30 coins anyways. Hey, look, another cat bell. It only gives me points, but that's fine. So now I can jump up, climb. So I can cat climb the pole. But that's only if you get enough height. I still can't tell if this is too loud for the recording. I'm trying to adjust the sound. But now I have almost 300 coins! And the foundation is complete! Yay! Whew. Nice. Just magical poof. Now I'm 3% done. The foundation's complete! It's even bigger than it was before. Castle's gonna be rock solid. Okay, let's get the castle rebuilt. Where do you want to start? I don't have enough coins for any of it. Please do some more of the taskmaster's job. We need more coins. So you have 2 more jobs? Final word of advice. Talk to the chief when you complete. He usually has something new for you to build. Back to work. Some new jobs just came in. And I'm not gonna do it. The Angry Sun. These are like, all these are more difficult levels. Let's try the Angry Sun. I don't think I'd want to know what the Angry Sun is, but I don't think I have a choice. There's the Angry Sun. Hello, Angry Boy. Yeah. So whenever he does that weird thing, he's gonna come in for a swoop. There. So now some good sounds. I still don't really know how to use all the power-ups. I know that the A and B buttons do will make you jump, and the X and Y buttons make you use the special thing, but I don't know if that's the same for the for all of the power-ups. The sun looks very different. Probably since it's not supposed to be in this version. I'll be taking that, thank you. probably read some of the guides or like what everything does.
What?
Swings around too much. Yeah, it really wants you to keep that the pillar suit, doesn't it? I'm not good at this game. Maybe if I double click, that's how it works. Maybe there's another button?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, I know. Assist parts. I could give myself some extra parts and stuff if it's too difficult, but hopefully I won't need that. I'll just use what the course gives me. If that's not good enough, well then that's just my luck. Maybe there's like a special button for it. That's not it. Need some time to practice. And now I'm small again. This is too hard. With only a few lives left, it'd be better if I tried something else. Say, there's a Mario's boobs. I just glanced at that right before I did that.
Mamma mia.
It's not here, it's during the level. No, I don't want the sun. Let's try the Haunted Manor. See if that can help us. I'm glad that Luigi has a bigger part in this game. It's like, there's always invisible blocks, right? Anything? Get the P-switch. Or maybe just saying I need to find them. What about here? If I didn't know this was a course stage, I'd think that this was made by a terribly... Darn it, there's a yellow. This is fun! Once I get more used to this game, it'd be even more fun. Like that. I definitely need a P-switch to get to that lower door, but there's no P-switch in here. And the first door just leads to the ghost, so it'd be better if I go through there. Are these like the other types of Goombas, but they're just like in this version? Yoshi! This is definitely a good level. Too bad I only have a limited number of lives.
Oh yeah.
I bet you if I run out of lives, I'm going to have to like wait a certain amount of time before I can try again. That's usually how it works, these types of stages. So I need the Yoshi. I can turn these guys. Just turn all of them. Just come down. There we go. Let's go through the door. Maybe my pal Yoshi can help us. Of course, Yoshi still can't walk on coins. You need to get the P-switch for that. But I think I can. Yeah, I can get the P-switch. Nice. Okay. Oh. Must went too far. I don't want the red guy to. There we go. Quick, into the door! Come on! Darn it. Wait, you can put P-switches on ceilings? Well, that's a big difference. Where does this door lead, though? What was that? Oh, is that like a reset door? But like the screen goes black and white for a split second. And now the screen goes all glitchy. How do we get off Yoshi? Oh, there we go. There we go. Got the 10 coins. My gold coiner is here. But I need to go further up. As you saw, my thing has low batteries, so after I beat this level, I'm probably going to end this video. It's funny how the screen does that. They have a lot of new sound effects and stuff. That was a key locked door. Okay. There's like a scroll thing. I wonder what's down, but for now I just need to go up. That. What's here? Oh, I just invisible locks. Oh well. I guess I'll have to go through the store. All the doors keep taking me back to the beginning. That glitch effect, I don't like it. It hurts my eyes. Now that I'm here, I'm not good at parkour, but in this stage, even if you're not good at parkour, it doesn't matter, because this stage is all centered around timing. Of course, if you're not good at timing, then it just restarts. So. But hey, you get infinite tries until the time runs out, of course. And if it becomes too hard, I can always just place a piece of which using my creator mode, but what kind of chump would do that? Not me. There! Got all the coins. Wait, is that supposed to get through here? I guess there's like a secret bonus if you get there fast enough. Should I just do it? Eh, it's not worth it. I saw there's like a 30 coin thing down there. Maybe that's what it would be. Wait a second. This looks like the same room as before, except it's not. I like the colored pipes. That's a nice touch. This just brings me up here. There we go. Nice. Yeah, so that seems like all I have time for. This video is definitely going to take some time to edit, but hopefully it should be out before next week. Okay. So, see you later, guys, and I hope you have a nice day, everyone.